We're still hanging out with the very talented and super funny Kenan Thompson. Okay, now you've got a new sitcom called Kenan, which you were filming while also working on Saturday Night Live. And your SNL castmate, Chris Redd, plays your brother on the show. So you guys literally were flying back and forth from New York to LA nonstop. How much fun was it to work and travel with him?
It's the best, man. Like, Chris is my brother. I owe him, you know, so very much. Like, if it wasn't for Chris, I wouldn't have an Emmy. You know, I would probably still be on the nominations list waiting to win or something like that. But that dude is incredibly talented and gracious. And we built something that was special with Chance with that Comeback Barack song. But to have him on the show as my brother is just a reflection of how amazing God is. You know what I mean? Like, we did the pilot originally and he wasn't in it. And it was cast basically outside of SNL because it's, you know, kind of off limits, SNL cast people. You know, you never think that you can just put them in your show unless you just develop the show from scratch with them. And that wasn't necessarily the case. But since the pilot came out kind of whatever-ish and we got a chance to redevelop the show, Lauren was like, you know, let's surround you with, like, you know, people that you're used to working with. And Chris was first on the list. And he was down to do it, and it's just been a gold mine ever since. Because, like I said, when you're in there with your friends and you're doing it, it doesn't feel like work. And to travel back and forth, it didn't feel exhausting at all because I was just in great company. You know what I mean? So I love that dude.
I love that. I can feel the love between the two of you. The billboard for the show, though, is everywhere. Now, did your kids seen it? What were their reactions if they did see it?
Yeah, we drove past it when they first went up, you know, and they all started screaming in the car. My wife and kids were like, look, 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 look. And even my little baby, my little two-year-old was like, look, daddy, daddy, daddy. So that brought a tear to the lump in my throat.
That's awesome.
that was good.
Aww. Oh, congrats on all that. And the show is about a widowed dad juggling his job as the host of an Atlanta morning show while raising two girls. So tell us what we can expect to see the rest of the season.
Yeah, I mean, so far, like, it's been about building the characters and letting everybody, you know, kind of get used to what the show is, right? So I'm hosting a morning show, but I'm also going through a widowship, and I have two girls, and Chris is my brother, and Don Johnson is my father-in-law, and they're all supposed to be helping, but they're really not. And then my workplace job, you know, I have my producer of the show played by the great Kimberly Lewis. She's so wonderful and talented. And we have our other co-anchors on the show, one Taylor Louderman, Fortune Feimster, and Jeff Lewis. I finally learned Jeff's last name. They're all incredibly funny and gifted, and it just took a while to kind of establish what the world is. So now we're later in the season, and everybody kind of knows what's going on, and we're just playing around. So I think, like, towards the end is like a big, you know, hair show convention or something, like representative of Atlanta, like kind of like mirroring the Bronner Brothers experience or whatever back in the day and stuff like that. And the kind of, you know, is there a love interest with Kimry and stuff like that? The will they, won't they type of thing, you know, just heats up basically.
That's what I like about it. I've been watching it. It's so refreshing and funny. Let's check out a clip of you in action on Kenan. Check it out.
Yeah. I can't believe I have to wear this stupid thing for the wedding.
Oh, it's cute. You look like a really accomplished Girl Scout.
Nah, he looks like he's going to a NASCAR funeral.
I feel like junk mail. I mean, what is messy water?
It's what we're drinking, dog.
The world's finest water-flavored malt beverage.
Water doesn't have a flavor.
That's the point. You can take it to the gym and no one knows. Mommy's little secret.
Now with 75% alcohol? Good Lord. What monster would make this? Let me guess. Geraldson's? Yep, of course.
They also make my daughter's adorable diaper thongs.
Diaper thongs!
You know, Kenan, you are so busy. You're already doing two shows, but you also have a podcast called You Already Know. What do you chat about on your podcast?
Parental advisory is fair warning. Just me and my buddy chatting about, it started with us chatting about a love for, like, movies and TV shows and stuff like that. And then the pandemic hit, and then a lot of our racial issues kind of hit and exploded over the summer. So we started just podding through that whole experience. And now we're, like, you know, 50 episodes deep and trying to just continue being two friends chatting about, you know, the Black experience, basically. whether that be about how it is in the street or how it is in your home. What do you enjoy watching? What do you enjoy talking about? You know, what you should be investing in financially, like all kind of like good life tips, basically. So shout out to my partner, Tony Maroli. You already know podcasts. But the whole point of doing the podcast was to start a podcasting company. And that's really what we did. So we have like 11 other pods that are coming underneath that, a whole kids thing and blah, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying? So that's really the bigger vision.
Wow. So smart. Speaking of your bigger vision, of all your career accomplishments, and there's so many, what has been the most meaningful to you?
I mean, I have to give the biggest credit to SNL, you know, just because that was the bridge between me being a kid star and an adult star or an adult entertainer, basically. A lot of people don't, you know, make that transition or they don't make it very well or anything like that. And SNL, I've been there for 18 years, and Nickelodeon, I was there for 6. So, like, I've tripled up my time there, and that was only because SNL gave me that stamp where adults can look at me as an adult and I'm able to go through my life and not have to fake being super young or trying to act older than my age. I can just be my age and entertain y'all. So I have to give it up for
them. You're so good at it.
You certainly entertain us. Kenan, thank you so much for stopping by and hanging out with us. We've had a blast talking about you.
Yeah, really. I appreciate it. Appreciate it. Y'all do y'all thing. I'm a big fan. I watch all the time, as you can see.
Thank you.
We love that. Yeah. Don't stop watching Kenan. Kenan airs on Tuesdays at 8:30, 7:30 Central on NBC.